also you started your life in London and London School of Advertisement and all that. You came to Nigeria as a young advertising executive and all that, and you started practicing in the biggest city in Africa, in Ibadan, and all that. So what ran you into problem with General Jemibewon, who was also a very young governor then? Why did you run into crisis with him and you have to run away from Ibadan and came to settle in Lagos?
You're asking of a long story. It's also in my book.
Okay, sir.
I started advertising and marketing in Britain. I returned to Nigeria December 1975. I got a job at WNTWNBS, which now became NTA and OYO, and it was a military regime. So the day I was going to resume was the day General Mutalama was killed. In fact, I was carrying my luggage from Lagos to Ibadan. We slept 3 days on the road
because of the coup.
So I was working at WNTWNBS as a commercial officer, and we normally schedule commercials, Star Beer and all that. And one day we got a new film from PZ. That film is Joy Soap.
Yeah, new product.
It's not a new product, okay. But they changed their film, okay. Commercial. So we started in that thing, and the girl getting was almost a nude lady, okay. Bra and small bra and pant, okay. And the girl was Joy, you know.
The very night
we showed the first one. We just saw soldiers in, because they were very close at Agodi. Okay, that, who are those people? They came there, and our general manager was Vincent Maduka.
The same old one.
Huh? No, it's not late. Huh? I think it's still around. Okay. He became DG of NTA.
Yeah.
Then Yemi Farombi, yeah, was also there. And when they came now, yes, when they came there now, they arrested all of us, took us to Jemibewon. Why did you show a woman nakedly? You know, in those days, I see decency.
Yes, sir.
If it's this day, everybody will clap. Then we were asked to kneel down on stone, you know.
Kneel down on stone, okay. Manager, sir. Executive manager, sir. With your suit and everything, sir.
So, even my senior was there. So when we finished, I just said,
on stone, sir.
I can't believe it.
So, yes. Even not because they begged for, they will have shaved her head. So that shows you the discipline of those days. Today, now, you can even walk naked and people will clap for you. So it was a bad experience, and I said, I came from UK, all of a sudden to be humiliated. So I came back to Lagos, and I got a job, and that was it. And I said bye-bye to Ibadan.
The humiliation of Nigeria, humiliation of Nigeria from UK. That's interesting. But when you saw General Jemibewon, how did you view him then?
I met him later in life. I was working.
Literally the experience.
Yes, I was working at Grant Advertising, okay. And I was handling the Eco Hotels account.
Okay.
And in those days, the chairman of Grant Advertising was J.K. Randu.
Okay, the same. J.K. Randu.
Still see the chairman.
Yeah.
So we used to organize Eco Hotels exhibition, and one of the part of the exhibition is novelty match.
Okay.
So I organized novelty match between retired soldiers, you know, and staff of
Eco Hotel.
And Jemibewon came to play for he played defense. So that day I said, oh God, you know me. Say, I don't know your missionary, but I know missionaries. My uncle Duke missionary in Ibadan. I said, yeah. I said, well, you remember one of the missionaries that worked at WNTWNBS that showed me. He said, he held on to me and grabbed me. I said, but you punished me. He said, no, that's military discipline. And he was never sorry.
Why can't you sue him?
No, he was a soldier. He was never sorry. He said, that's it now. That in those days, that, you know. So, the soldiers, they did a lot of things against our psyche.
I understand now.
Like the senator that slapped a girl,
yeah,
at the shop.
Yes,
that's
Senator Abu.
It's military psyche.
Yeah.
That, you know, you can deal with people.
I get away.
And we are just about to get away from it, but still, no. We are still there. Buhari is a soldier. Not until we start having a non-soldier as president, as governors. When you look at it, all of them in power are still ex-soldier. Mm-hmm. So the military thing, I can do it all, and nothing will happen, is still there.
Mm-hmm.
Till today now, soldiers go to police station, beat DPO, beat DCO, and nobody will ask a word.
Even they go into a state and beat people.
But very soon things will change. France went through it. General de Gaulle was the president, but today you can't even see traces of. In England, you know, so many ex-soldiers. But our democracy should be allowed to grow. And things will change gradually.